Greetings, everybody. Hello and welcome at long last to Shovel Knight. As most of you are probably already aware, at least if you watched the previous channel update, this is a game I've been wanting to play for quite some time. And unfortunately, running a channel like this one, you invariably end up with a really large backlog of games that you desperately want to play, but either don't have the time to play, or only have the time to play on your own time, but want to save them for your channel. And that's more or less what has happened to Shovel Knight ever since its release, God, last year now. So, lest I sit at the title screen talking, as is my usual bad habit, let's get this started. And while I'm doing that, I do want to mention a couple of things. I've set up a profile already, but I haven't done anything yet. This is just for ease of getting everything configured and starting off the video in a timely fashion. But it bears mentioning, first of all, that I am not playing this completely blind, just because it's been basically impossible to avoid any kind of spoilers whatsoever since the game has been out as long as it has, which is okay with me. And also, I should apologize while I'm thinking of it for any traffic noise you all might hear in the background, since I'm trying to make the best of my weekend and am recording this during the day. But yes, I'm not playing this totally blind, just because I've been unable to avoid learning a little bit about it over the course of the time it's been out, in retail, that is. But that does not diminish my desire to play it. I'm not really terribly concerned with spoilers, and I've talked about this before as well, working on the strategy guides for Bloodborne and Dark Souls 2. It doesn't bother me. I completely understand it bothering other people, but I don't personally get terribly bent out of shape about it. And I think there are still plenty of surprises that this game has to offer me. Sharpen thy shovel. So, let me just familiarize myself with the controls here. I should also mention, I suppose, that I'm playing this with a DualShock 4 controller, but unfortunately all of the button prompts in the game are for the 360. So let me just... okay, that's menu. This is game menu. That's select, I guess. Square is attack, triangle does nothing. Circle is also attack, X is jump. Analog stick and direction pad are move. Okay. Alright, and shoulder buttons do nothing, apparently. I love that you can just dig stuff up out of these piles of dirt, and I'm guessing... okay. Alright. Whoa! I seem to recall that... oh, it's just hold down in the air to do the downward stab. Okay. This reminds me a lot of Zelda 2, this downward stab. As to the controls themselves, it's actually kind of slow. Shovel Knight moves somewhat ponderously, but it's not slow in a way that feels clunky or out of place. It feels very purposeful. And I don't feel like I have an insufficient amount of control over him. I know there are a bunch of secret areas and hidden things in the game as well, and I'm gonna try and keep my eyes peeled for them. Nothing there, I guess. Bouncing on blocks and other things in the terrain that actually give you some additional airtime. It's very satisfying. It's really the horizontal momentum. Oh, I didn't realize those damage you. Oops. So you have to bounce on them. Okay. Damn it. Boy, I'm still getting used to the controls. This branch here. This looks like it might indicate something secret. Oh, and the bubble just it just stays. Okay. Alright, so I've got to wait for it to get a little bit higher off the ground. Okay. Yeah, no, it feels good. I guess this is a checkpoint. I am aware that you can destroy those for money or leave them and allow them to actually serve as a checkpoint. But it feels right. The controls are very smooth, and the only real problem here is my lack of experience with this game. But what I like so far is that already it just has that nostalgic feel of an NES game, or an SNES game, I guess, really. And that appeals to me on a deep and visceral level, just, I guess, because that was the generation that I started in, the NES. Oh, okay, and you can bounce on his back without damaging him. His weak point is his head, it seems. All right. That, again, that felt very good. Let's see. Oh! Okay! Now, see, that's a fun mechanic. That doesn't even have to exist, but it does. And the fact that it does is just awesome. It adds that little bit of color, I guess, and it just makes the gameplay feel more interesting. These cute little things in the environment that they don't have to be there, but the fact that there's that one extra thing you can destroy. Okay, so this clearly... Alright, so it seems that what I'm looking for in the environment is those little X's, or... Oh, see, now that's gonna be hard to identify if you're not really looking for it. They're introducing you to the different types of terrain that you can destroy here. That's good, I like that, where they show it to you, but they don't shove it down your throat, and if you're not paying attention, then you can very easily miss it. And clearly over here, there's one of those. They give you an opportunity. Let's see. Yeah, this... Everything about it feels intuitive. The music is pretty great, too. This, I believe the soundtrack for this game was done by Jake Kaufman. I think... He might also... I'm trying to remember what other ones he did. I can't remember if he worked on V or not. I think that was somebody else. But Jake Kaufman is known for chiptune-style soundtracks, and he's damn good at making them. He was absolutely the right person for this game. And I like also that you have to be careful about how much of the environment you destroy, because see, if I had just broken all of these blocks, I would not have been able to reach this. And I actually apparently already missed that because I didn't bounce on... Oh no, you know what? I bet I can wait for this little slime to come over here and reach that. Come on. Just a little bit more. There we go. Yeah, see, just... The amount of thought and care that went into the level design and enemy placement is abundantly evident just in this first opening stage. I mean, God, I can only imagine what it's like in the game proper. I like also that you're not kind of coerced into rushing through a stage. You can. I have seen some partial speedruns, just little sections, mainly, I guess, highlights of speedruns of this game. And some of the techniques I've seen people use have been just utterly astonishing. I almost think that there were some aspects of this game that either the devs left in specifically for speedrunners that might not have been intentional, but they just said, yeah, you know what? People who do want to speedrun the game are going to love this. We'll leave it in. And they did. And I love that. I love the idea of a game that is community friendly, and where as long as something is not blatantly game breaking, it can be left in for the enjoyment of the community and not just erased by the debug team. Let's see. Okay, so clearly there is another, Oh, interesting. And If I destroy this, I won't be able to reach the ladder, so I wonder how this is going to be handled. Oh, okay. I see what they've done. You know, I really like that. That's great. They still left me some recourse, even if I did destroy it. Now, is there anything over that way? Because that looks an awful lot like... it should be something. But I guess not, so... wait a minute now. Aha! Okay, now that... that was brilliant, but I didn't really see an indication of the terrain that would have... oh, it's automatic, you just... ah, I love that. That is brilliant. And see, now... now I'm tempted to go back and destroy those previous checkpoints. I wonder how far they'll let me backtrack here. See how much those give me. It might not be worth it. Come on. I know I can break these things. Can't I? It's beginning to look like I might not be able to break this. Oh, you know what? I guess you can't break it if you've already activated it. I wonder if maybe that's the case. Let's try it with the one up here. No? Hmm. Maybe it's just the ones in the tutorial stage that can't be broken. I'm honestly not sure about that. Hmm. See that? That looks like it'd be something secret too, just where there's little bits of leaf in the terrain, but... out over here. No, it doesn't look like it. Okay. Alright, let's see. So they've raised the stakes here. They've upped the ante on me. And they've added a pit that I'll fall into if I miss. I like that. Alright. Really? You just... okay. I guess I'll take it. Wait a minute, though. There's gotta be more to it. Okay, maybe not. See, that little branch sticking out into that pit makes it look like there might be a secret area down there. But I don't want to risk it. I don't want to jump down there and find out, because I have a feeling it's quite possibly just a troll. I also like that there are, there's money in these blocks. It's kind of a nice way of giving you a reward for destroying stuff, and also encouraging you to break things in the environment. Interesting as well that there are these little slime enemies hidden in the grass. Got some nice parallax environments going on here. I like that as well. Can I reach the ladder? Yes, I can. Excellent. Clearly a secret over here. Maybe not even really a secret. But a chest, at any rate. Now, one of the things I'm very suspicious of is secrets within secrets. Because I'm fairly sure there are in this game, and... it's definitely something that I would not put past Yacht Club. Oh, look at this. Ah! I love that it's not exactly wall chicken, but it's basically wall chicken. That's fantastic. And the tower in the background, clearly this is our rival character. The Cerulean Coward. Get out of my way, I don't want to fight. Okay. Yes, I'm kind of aware of that. Thanks to that nice intro sequence. Steal thy shovel. Now, I'm not sure if this is supposed to be a pun, but ordinarily there would be an E on the end of the word steal here. It's a different term entirely. Oh, that laugh! In before he takes off his helmet and it's just Kefka. Oh, he's got the downward stab too. I really like that. It's the kind of... Whoa. He demonstrates that he has the same capabilities I do, which a rival character should. Okay, I think I'm catching on here. Yeah, throw that fireball at me. That's what I thought. A good rival character should be able to do everything you can, but they should be better at it. Oh, God. I'm getting destroyed. There. Sheesh. So he just pisses off. Oh, this is nice. Perhaps a not-so-subtle reference to the Souls games, but then again, that's an easy conclusion to jump to. Oh no! It's Shield Knight! I believe I have to catch her here. Oh, and it slows down. Okay. So there is some element of challenge to that. It's not quite as easy as it probably looks in the footage. What are all those noises? I'm not... Oh, okay, I actually had to press something to get up. I didn't realize that. Well... You know, I was about to make that exact comment. Only you can prevent forest fires by putting them out and burying the embers, making sure that they're completely quenched before you leave. I wonder if you can actually end up causing a forest fire if you don't do that. Oh, God. All right, we've got our world map. We've got the good old cloud cover. Let's see. Appears to be nothing here. This, I guess, is a village. Okay. Oh, and I can't even pass the village yet. All right, I guess we're going to the village. Swords? What are you, blind? Press up to talk? Okay. Hey, Santa! Give me some presents. Head to the juice bar for fresh squoze juice.
Morning, noon, or night!
Okay. What? Wait a minute. Stop right there. Why are you a horse? Try fishing. Okay. What? Oh. But... I didn't want to leave town. Cause no trouble. This Isn't that a line from some other game? Cause no trouble? Dear lady. Okay, so I guess that's just a thing in this world. Anthropomorphic.
I remember before the Order of No Quarter when we weren't afraid to walk around like this.
Oh. Okay. So I guess it's just one-liners. I like to look nice on my day off. Yeah. Okay, sure. I have a feeling there are going to be a lot of shovel puns in this game. So, this is a little bit strange. It's up to initiate a conversation, but I have to press X to actually advance the dialogue. That's always annoyed me a little bit. I wish it were just the same button for both. Trouple King, I'll have to remember him. Did you know your fishing rod can haul up faraway bags and gems out of your reach? It's the truth. Okay, well, I'll remember that. Lost all my music sheets, eh? I think I found a couple of those. Okay. Oh, and I've got a couple. Yeah, great. Sure, I'll take 500 gold for each. Oh, and he's even outright identified as the rival. Should have studied composition. Yeah, fair enough. Great. Oh, alright, so this is basically your sound test. I really like that. Oh, what? Why tell me that if I already know it and I'm already doing it? She can't even see my face, I'm wearing a helmet! Old village is overrun with the undead and Spectre Knight. Barely made it out in time. Jeez, that doesn't sound very good. Okay, so these appear to be just generic NPCs. Can I go into houses? Does not appear that I can. Wait, what? What are you freaking out about, man? Alright. Oh, okay. Gastronomer? I don't think that's a real profession. Potage and poultry, mutton and meat. Your maximum health will increase if you eat. Ah! Well written! Oh, but I need a special item. Goatician? Well, probably this goat-looking guy down here. Yes, indeed. Goatician, though. Also, probably not a real profession. Should I extend my magic or health, or just eat a tin can? Yes, goats will eat a tin can if you give them the opportunity. Why not buy my meal ticket and help narrow... Wait a minute, what? Buy my meal ticket and help narrow down my options? You mean you don't want to use your meal ticket? Oh, and it's just... okay. Fair enough. Can I buy another one from him right away? I can! Oh god! But they get quite a bit more expensive. You know what though? You can't put a price on maximum health. And I love that when you buy it, this guy starts freaking out. Come over here! Look at me! Talk to me with that item you just bought that you're supposed to use here! Oh, and he identifies how many you have! I wonder if they'll actually all just get combined into one transaction. Pardon the mess. Oh, wow. What? Oh. Oh, that looks pretty good. Oh, he does combine. What the? At that. What even is that? Okay! Well, that first thing looked good, but that second one? Oh, I'm not so sure. Okay, well, What have we got over here, then? Use out of your relics. No relics. Okay, so actually, it's probably a good thing I spent all my gems there. Chester down the ladder. Okay, maybe it's not good. Should I have saved some money for one of those relics? Or do I still have enough to buy one? None of these guys look like they sell relics. None of these guys really do either. Croaker. Oh, God. So this guy is just... Ah! And look at him, he thinks he's hot shit after making a stupid pun. What's this dude? Truple Acolyte? Fish friend? What? Doesn't look the least bit like a fish. Bye. Okay, so I can't afford any of these yet. Wouldn't believe the merchandise I've got for you today. This guy already sounds pretty sketch, but clearly this is Chester. So... we can get a fishing rod, cast into a pit and wait for a bite, or a chaos sphere? Boundless combat potential. Alright, so clearly I need quite a bit more money before I can come back here and do anything for- Wait a minute. Something is suspicious. Aha! I'm proud I noticed that. What about the rest of these people? Juice maid. So I guess this is supposed to be a juice bar, then? Oh, okay, well, I guess I'll come back after I've beaten Spectre Knight. King Knight sits on Pridemore's throne. That gilded goon. Oh, okay, so I guess King Knight booted this guy out. Grandma Swamp! I wonder if this is something that resulted from a donation by the Zaibatsu. Useless infos. Oh, so I guess this is where you go if you want to learn what statistics of yours the game is tracking. That's pretty cool, I like that. Oh, and of course, they do track your total playtime. I guess I shouldn't be surprised. What have we here? Suppose peaceful solitude is too much to ask for, as long as I'm stranded here. Stranded here? What? 100 gold. Alright. Hit them toward the targets for points. Okay, yeah, sounds like fun. Oh, okay. Oh, I see how this works. Think. Oh, but clearly I'm not great at it. Yes, I am indeed not great at it. So there's glowing ones. Well, I earned back more than I spent, and I got some music. So this might actually allow me to go turn in these sheets and- Whoa! Did Did not mean to talk to you, no. See, I feel like the only problem I've encountered so far is that talking really should just be, should just be unified to a button that isn't used, and triangle to- Oh, see, if somebody has something to do when you interact with them, they start tweaking out. That's awesome, I do like that. Alright. Spin the bottle. And yes, the word is written Y-E, but it's actually pronounced the. The client's only reaction was, oh, okay, I guess, whatever. Sorry, was it not brooding enough for you? Okay. Well, now that I have some money again, I guess I'm going to go buy whatever looks most important. Probably a relic, considering. What can I afford? See, I feel like it should be the attack button to talk. Since there are two attack buttons, it should be maybe circle to talk and square to attack in a town. I don't know, I just... Alright, anyway. So I can't afford the Chaos Sphere, but the fishing rod does seem like it might be useful. Hold up and press square. Cast into a pit and wait for a bite. Keep an eye out for sparkly fishing spots. Okay. Fair enough. Ah. Alright. Great. Well, I think I'm going to keep these to half-hour episodes. I think that seems just about right for a game like this, so I'm going to wrap it up here. Thank you all for joining me, and I look forward to seeing everybody next time.